Hey everyone, welcome to round one. We have lost the roll and we're on the draw, which is kind of awkward with Vivid Mitto, Search for Mo, and that nonsense, because we can't, if we don't draw land, then we're not going to be able to lead with Vivid Mitto to suspend this, and then suspend this Giant Dusk Clasp on two. So we're not going to mulligan, though. I mean, this hand's decent. Well, let's go ahead and see what we draw for our first turn in terms of land. Nope. Okay, so now what I think I want to do is get this Thalid Shell Dweller in play. I mean, we can just sort of gamble that we actually get a land for turn two. And that would work out pretty well. But I really want to be able to get these guys out. So I'm just going to go ahead and make sure that we get them to two mana as opposed to just banking on a 50-50. Yeah, it looks like we would have gotten there, so I'm going to go ahead and suspend the Dust Wasp. Then next turn we can play Search and suspend, or suspend Search and then play Thalid Shell Dweller. And we got nothing, so let's see if we're playing against a Pestermite. Nope. Cast that guy and suspend this guy. And ship the turn. Then we can play Spore Sower into Sporloth into Thalid Germinator. And then we'll have all sorts of cool stuff. Careful consideration. That's fine. Well, I mean, it's not really fine, but he's not adding to the board. Let's see, what are we discarding? It looks like it's an island and a spell. Another island. Well, he's got a lot of cards. So we're just going to stack all of our triggers, always yield to everything, because we really only want to go through this once. And go ahead and play our Sporloth. And a combination of Sporloth and Spore Sower is going to make it so that we end up getting a lot of sapling tokens. So the Thalid Germinator is going to be pretty awesome. And let's see, yeah, we got all this stuff going on. Always yield to that. And we're gonna get a land on the battlefield. Let's see. So we're gonna go ahead and get a swamp, I guess. And so now we'll go ahead and play this Sporloth Ancient. I'm gonna attack. Right, what do we have? It's a Pestermite. Le Pestermite. It's tapping our Sporloth. Boom goes the dynamite. That's fine. And we've got the combination of Sporloth Ancient, oh my, City of Wrath, this guy's in the money. No blockers. We've got the Dust Wasp plus another Dust Wasp, so we're pretty safe from flyers at the moment. Let's see what he adds to the battlefield. Latchkey Fairy, oh no, drew a card. And another Latchkey Fairy, jeez. Should have played this Dust Wasp, as it looks like. Just drawing a ton of cards. So probably going to be holding this guy back and playing our Dust Wasp. And let's remove two counters to make us a guy. Put everything on the stack. Always yield to that. So now what can we do? Well, got a few options. We can play this Thalid Germinator, and that would make it so that our Dust Wasp can block a Latchkey Fairy. Alternatively, if we play this, and that would make it so that one, two, three, we can attack with these, all of these, and he can't double block. The problem is that let's see, one, two, we're attacking for a lot, so If he has something like Aether Snipe, then we're in a little bit of trouble. But I think that this is okay, because we'll be able to hit him for a bunch of damage, and then next turn we can replay this Dust Wasp, or play the Dust Wasp. We don't really know what he has in his hand. So if he goes Tromp the Domains, we're not dead. We'd be down to one life, so I think we're just going to go ahead and play this guy pre-combat and see what happens. And then we can attack with everything, I think. See what he wants to do. I think it's better to attack with this, because it's there are a lot of cards that really punish us for holding this guy back. And he's single blocking. That's interesting. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and just ship the turn now. Then next end of turn we can make three tokens. And we get three more. So with the Thalagerm here, this is really going to be a complicated board for him. Even if he plays Aether Snipe and bounces one of our creatures, maybe the Dust Wasp. He would actually probably bounce the Sporsaur Thalid. But, I mean, this is going to be difficult for him, I think. Alrighty, looks like he's going to attack. And he's attacking with just one. Alright, I'm liking where this is heading, so let's go ahead and see what we're playing against now. That was quite a turn from him last turn, just double Latchkey Fairy. Thought we were certainly in trouble. Now, he's just all about the latchkeys. So let's see where we are. Probably gonna break this bad boy for something. Like a mountain or island, and then hopefully crush him. Getting three more tokens and then three more tokens. Executioner's Capsule. That is not going to quite do it. It's a little slow, so let's go ahead and break that. And then remove some spore counters. Showing us X. Oh, what does he have? Electrolyze. Two tokens, you say? Well, I think I'm going to go ahead and sack this one to give this one plus one, plus one. And let's see. He's got two blockers, so we've got one, two biggest attackers. It's three, four, five, six. Got a trigger in the stack. Seven, eight, nine, ten, 11. So he's just dead. So we don't actually need to show him any more cards. We'll auto yield to that, then just go about our business. So that was pretty sweet. Look at that. This guy's got some blue cards. And we'll just go ahead and attack with everything. He is probably in a little bit of trouble. And yep, there we go. Alright, so these Plume Veils are probably pretty good. I think we can actually get rid of this. See, Plume Veil is going to be a little tricky because we have. Let's see, what did he have? He had Mountains, so these Hillcombers are also probably okay. And Otherworldly Journey is probably. Let's see, we've got Hammerheim Deadeye. These Hillcombers are probably not the best, actually. And what else is okay? I feel like I want to take out the Stone Hero Giant and these two. Alternatively, casting Plume Veil is pretty difficult when you don't have too many white sources, so we could just go down to a straight red green-white splash red. Like one mountain for like an extra Tromp. Tromp feels like it's going to be a little on the gratuitous side. So that would mean that we would take out Skyreach Man is probably still fine. What happens then? So we can swap that. So in there, it goes in there, that goes in there, that goes in there. Take Test of Faith out. Doesn't really help against Executioner's Capsule, although it does against Electrolyze. Just feels like this swamp and is completely unnecessary. It's just gonna be a liability. So we're gonna go ahead and add another island or plains. Let's see, what else? It's probably good enough. This Etched Oracle could probably just be another land. Like, we can turn it into an Amru Scout, which would be another Saltfield Recluse. Or a land. Or an Otherworldly Journey. I think I'd rather just turn it into an Otherworldly Journey. Skyreach Manta. Let's see. An island, mountain. Should be fine. So let's try that.